Sometimes the quantity of inventory changes, but not just for buying and selling. We have to make special adjustments to inventory whenever the quantity of inventory changes for any other reason besides buying, selling, or returning merchandise. Now you may ask, why would the inventory quantity change if you did not buy and sell, or if nobody returned to us or we did not return any merchandise to the vendor? What could be the reason the quantity of inventory changed? Well, number one, theft. It doesn't happen very often. It's not a normal part of business, but it is something that causes the quantity of inventory to change that is not buying, selling, or returning. A catastrophe, such as a fire, a flood, a tornado, earthquake, or some kind of damage where the building collapses, that would be an event that's rare, that's not part of normal business operation, but it would cause inventory to change in quantity. Spoilage. If we are in the apple and banana business, nothing spoils faster than apples and bananas. Sometimes we don't sell the apples and bananas fast enough, and whatever spoils before we have a chance to sell is a loss to us that changes the quantity of inventory without any event actually happening. And of course, sometimes we can actually donate inventory to a charity. And these would be four of several reasons why inventory quantity would change without buying, selling, or returning. So if those are the reasons that inventory changed, what we need in our accounting records is an expense account in the chart of accounts for each of the different reasons why inventory quantity changed without buying or selling. Let's make three of them now. Let's make a T account in the chart of accounts for loss on theft, inventory loss on catastrophe, and inventory loss on spoilage. Just like we've done many times before, list chart of accounts, account new. These accounts are expense type of accounts. Click continue. Make sure your cap locks is on so we know that we added this account and not QuickBooks. Loss on theft. Now we can click save and new. An expense type of account will still be selected. Loss on casualty. That means fire, theft, flood, or some kind of impact that destroyed the inventory. Save and new. Loss on spoilage. And those will be the only three we add for now. Save and close, and we now have three accounts that will accumulate the total money we lost from our merchandise without buying and selling the merchandise, and the total amounts will accumulate in these accounts. Let us now imagine that on June 13, we opened the inventory warehouse and observed that 10 apples had been stolen. The cost of those 10 apples is the amount of the loss on the theft. Let's take a look at how we enter it. We click Vendors, Inventory Activities, Adjust Quantity Value on Hand. That's where you click to adjust the inventory quantity for something other than a purchase, sale, or return. Now, the date that we observed that was June 13. So we go forward to June 13. Now, the adjustment account is the account that we accumulate the loss for the reason we lost it. In this case, it's loss on theft. Now we have to select the item. We lost apples. Now, the quantity difference is the amount of apples that we put that the inventory changed. If it is a decrease, we put negative 10 and push tab. Notice, the old quantity on hand was 283. Once you put the quantity difference, especially as negative, the new quantity will be the decreased amount. When we click Save and Close, we can open our trial balance and we notice for the first time we have loss on theft showing up for the cost of that inventory, $100. And of course, the account inventory asset has decreased by that $100. If we double click, we can come down and see inventory adjustment is the type of transaction. June 13th, Apple's $100 decreasing the inventory account. Notice this very same inventory adjustment showed up here in the inventory valuation detail, making a minus to the quantity of apples. If we need to see what we put, we can double click and go back to the very window that we recorded it. What about this event? June 14, opened the inventory warehouse and observed that 20 bananas had been spoiled. The cost of those bananas is the amount of loss on spoilage. So we do what we did before. We click Vendors, Inventory Activities, Adjust Quantity Value. The date that we noticed that was June 14, but this time it's not a loss on theft. This time it's a loss on spoilage. We have to know the difference between the money amount of inventory we're losing on theft compared to the money amount of inventory that we're losing on spoilage. The item was bananas. And of course, the quantity difference in this case was 20. So if we lost 20 bananas, we put minus 20 as the quantity difference. When we push tab, we notice QuickBooks calculates the new quantity of bananas on hand. When we click Save and Close, we can see in the trial balance, for the very first time, loss on spoilage showed up in the trial balance as $400, because $400 is what we paid for the 20 bananas that were spoiled. We can also see this on the inventory valuation detail. Inventory adjustment on June 14th, minus 20 to the quantity of bananas, making the quantity of bananas go down to 503.